Thank you. I feel welcome. Better keep walking on down here.
Пане президент Сполучених Штатів Америки, високоповажні зарубіжні гості, дорогі співвітчизники.
Dear President of the United States of America, dear guests, dear compatriots.
Сьогодні нас звела тут трагічна дата. 50-річчя масових розстрілів у Бабиному Яру.
We have been brought together here today by the tragic date, the 50th anniversary of the mass execution at Babin Yar.
Саме тут півстоліття тому, день у день, гриміли постріли, падали підступно підкошені, мирні люди, лилася невинна кров.
Right here, half a century ago, day after day, shots could be heard, and peaceful people were falling insidiously cut down by the bullets, and innocent blood was flowing.
2000 євреїв, а згодом перетворили Яр у величезну братську інтернаціональну могилу євреїв, українців, росіян, поляків, представників інших національностей.
It was on the 29th of September 1941 that the Nazi occupation troops started here on this beautiful site, one of the most horrible actions of the Second World War, a huge international communal grave for the Jews, Ukrainians, Russians, Poles, representatives of other nations.
Гинули старики, діти, військовополонені, в'язні концентраційних таборів, матроси, офіцери Дніпровської флотилії.
The gunfire.
Висницька оргія, яка повинна стати пересторогою всьому людству.
That devil's dance of death, that misanthropic orgy, which lasted for 2 years, should become a warning to mankind.
Вона сьогодні боляче нагадує нам про жахливу небезпеку воєн, расових і національних конфліктів.
Even today, these memories are, has echoed mournfully in the hearts of the peoples of the world.
Яскравим доказом цього є і ваша присутність тут на трагічному полігоні тих зловісних часів, пане президент.
And an eloquent proof of this is, Mr. President, your presence here on the tragic site of those ominous times.
У цьому акті ми вбачаємо високу людяність президента Сполучених Штатів Америки, його готовність розділити людське горе невинних жертв. Від імені їх рідних і близьких, всіх людей доброї волі, ми звертаємося до вас, пане президент, а в вашій особі до всього американського народу, словами глибокої подяки за гуманізм, щире співчуття та співстраждання.
That is why here, at this sacred place, where thousands and thousands of innocent martyrs have perished on behalf of their relations, all people of goodwill, we address you, Mr. President, and through you, all American nation, with the words of deep gratitude for your humanism, sympathy, and compassion.
Тут, на цьому Олімпії людського горя та скорботи, з особливою силою та животворною надією,
that the words of Thomas Jefferson, immortalized in the Declaration of Independence, sound with particular strength and hope. All men are endowed with inalienable rights, among which are life, liberty, and pursuit of happiness.
Нехай же попіл загиблих, що стукає в наші серця, стане надійною запорукою того, що завдяки миротворцям...
Thank you, Chairman Kravchuk. And to our special guest today, the survivor of Bobiyar massacres and the Ukrainians who helped rescue them, it is my great honor to be with you today. We come to Bobiyar to remember. We remember violence and valor. We remember prejudice and selflessness. At Bobiyar, in the vast quiet here, something larger than life. The wind that shakes the leaves bears a special weight, as if whispering warnings and cautions, telling tales of victims and villains, cowards and heroes. Bobiyar stands as a monument to many things. It reminds us that history gives our lives meaning and continuity, and that any nation that tries to repudiate history, tries to ignore the actors and events that shaped it, only repudiates itself. For many years, the tragedy of Bobiyar went unacknowledged, but no more. You soon will place a plaque on this site that acknowledges the genocide against Jews, the slaughter of gypsies, the wanton murder of communists, Christians, of anyone who dared oppose the Nazi madman's fantasies. Bobiyar reminds us of the sheer stupidity of prejudice. And here we think about people of great promise and talent, young men and women who would have become doctors or physicists, athletes or artists. Mothers, fathers, all died because a maniac in Berlin wanted to exterminate their kind. The statue here testifies to an important truth. Just as bricks and stones shape great monuments, families shape nations. The love of parents, the trust of September 29th, 1941, soldiers forced men, women, and children to undergo a ritual of humiliation and death. Victims stopped first to empty their pockets at the edge of the ravine where marksmen murdered their prey, letting the bodies tumble into a long, deep pit. For 36 hours, rifle reports and shrill human cries shattered the calm. Nazis tried to drown out that horror by playing dance music over loudspeakers in the pages of history. When the first round of shooting stopped, more than 33,000 bodies lay in the pit, and many more people had committed suicide rather than undergoing the humiliating execution rites. Within 18 months, nearly 100,000 people perished here. Miraculously, a few managed to escape. Abraham Lincoln once said, "We cannot escape history." Mikhail Gorbachev, a future dedicated to freedom and individual liberty rather than to mob violence and tyranny. And we vow that whenever our devotion to principle wanes, Yevtushenko, whose poem about Bobiyar helped restore remembrance of this place and of its history. Here's what he wrote. "On Bobiyar, weeds rustle, the tall trees, like judges loom and threaten, all screams in silence. I take off my cap and feel that I'm slowly turning gray, and I too have become a soundless cry over the thousands that lie buried here. I am each old man slaughtered, each child shot, none of me will forget." Women opened their eyes, summoned their courage and faith, and fought for democracy, liberty, and justice, and decency. This memorial proves that eventually the forces of good and of truth will rise in triumph. And no matter how bleak our lives may seem, this fact should comfort us. It should inspire us to spare future generations from horrors like the one that claimed nearly 100,000 souls at Babi Yar. May God bless you all. May God bless Ukraine and its wonderful people. And may God bless the memories of Babi Yar.
I saw this gentleman. Is he here too? Thank you all very much. Many old veterans like me are out here.
Load up, guys. Load up. Oh, okay. Hold up. Hold up.
Service report, a wire service report that Ron has accepted.
I don't know enough about it to comment.
Where will the comment
be? I think it's very good.
Will it come to Washington?
Will you open it?